This is a Diana White Show Live. Welcome everyone from around the world and in the United States. We thank you so much for joining us. And we hope that we can say something to inspire you or to just encourage you this morning and give you the hope that you need. Just make sure, remember my words, you know, is hope, trust, believe, having some faith, and then pray. And wait patiently, patiently, patience. Patience is one of those things I pray for every single day, along with all the other things that you ask God for. But patience is truly a virtue. When you can be patient, it is indeed a good thing. So, we welcome you again from around the world and in the United States, and we thank you so much for joining us. And we are hoping that you will share the message that we're on. The Diana White Show is on live every day at 10:30 a.m. Monday to Friday. And Tuesday evenings, we're on at the 8 o'clock hour with Dr. Melanie Simpson. And as soon as the Ox gets back, we will be doing the men's show on Thursday evenings at 8 o'clock. So we just hope that you will spread the word and join us. Today is Tuesday, so it's time to hear from Judith from People 490 and see how the recruitment drive went on Saturday. I don't think there was any rain, so wow, Judith got lucky. So hope that folks went out in droves to support it. And, you know, because the key to all of things that we do is marketing. Marketing is the key. And if you listen to T.D. Jakes, he's doing a whole thing on businesses these days. And he said something quite interesting this morning that I just chuckled about when he talked about the fact that a church is actually a business. And, you know, but they're not supposed to talk about money. But people won't want to come to the church if the pews are broken down and if the electricity's out and there's no phone and there's no, you know, AC and all that kind of stuff. And I thought about it, yes. But they're just not allowed to say they must make a profit. But they have to make a profit to do what they do. So he is not ashamed or embarrassed to say this. And as usual, he's asking you to be faithful and know that if you're not going to make a profit, if you're starting a business to make a profit and you're not making a profit, obviously he's saying, you know, you're not going to make a profit in the first couple of years. Absolutely not. No business does unless you just get lucky. Boom, boom, boom. Like the young woman I was watching and her husband yesterday on the nightly news, and she started. After being broke, she started to write books. And then one book that she did just skyrocketed her to the number one spot on Amazon. And of course, T.D. Jakes is reminding you that if you're writing a book for Christians, you need to know what the CBA is. Christian Books Association, yes. Even if you don't know what it means, you should know the initials. Know your business. And take the time. And whatever you're planning to do, is your family going to be left out of it? Or is your family going to suffer because you have to take so much time to make this business profitable? I'm not willing to give up my family time for most things, especially when I have to do something for my daughter. I am just not willing to give that time up. Because to me, you choose to have children and you must do what they need to do to help them to succeed. So hence, I am not, that family thing, family time is not negotiable for me. I just believe that it's important. Family time is crucial. You must spend time with your children because they don't stay children for very long. Once they become teenagers, they act like they know everything anyway. And they act like they're your boss and you're not the boss anymore. So you got to spend time, especially in those early years, to not let someone else raise your kids, like a lot of these celebrities who allow their nannies to raise their children. Children are not pets or toys. if you choose to have them, you must put the time in to raise them. Simple. Now, even if you have them by accident, you should then decide if you're going to pursue the pregnancy and have them, you should then commit to raising them properly. And I think that's what's lacking in a lot of our young kids. They just have no guidance at home, and parents are becoming afraid of their children these days. Oh, because you're going to hurt their feelings. No! Hurt their feelings? If they do something wrong, you let them know that they did something wrong, something bad, something dangerous. But then they know you love them, so you tell them that you love them and confirm that you love them. But even though I love you, I cannot allow you to burn the house down. Or I cannot allow you to go as a young woman and sleep with this guy and the other guy and the next guy down the street. Because that's not what you're supposed to be doing. So how many of us as parents are bold enough to do that? I am one of those who are bold enough to do that, and you should be too. And as we move along in the journey of the Diana Wright Show every single day, we remind you to join the crusade with us. The I Love Me Crusade. That simply asks you to love yourself and stop trying to be someone else. Be who you are. Be grateful for who you are. If you want to adjust a few things, like get the nose job like NeNe Leakes, who thinks it made her more beautiful, go for it. But don't be stupid like this woman that I saw on television talking about she's making her breasts so big that she can't even sleep, and her children are laughing because they're showing that she can't even lie down. They should have to sleep like this. Stupid. We're not here to do stupid things. We're here to live a quality life at the best of our ability, of course. Because not all of us are going to be millionaires and Bill Gates and Zuckerberg, and we're just not all going to be Steve Jobs. We're not all going to be Oprah either. But be thankful and enjoy your moment. And even if the people that you gave that moment to do not appreciate you because they are envious and jealous, like those I know in the land of where I came from, even though you know that, you press on and forget about that. And even though sometimes you want to say something and you want to tell them off too, you just don't. Because you leave them to God. Because God will fix everything in due time, as long as you decide that you must have some patience. Lots of questions this morning, but before I get to the questions that I'm going to ask or put out to you this morning, I want to just ask you to like us on Facebook and tweet. As I write my tweets and I see, ooh, where are you? Why aren't you following? You need to follow and hear the good things about love. Because love, you see, is the greatest thing on this planet. We all need it. We all want it. We all seek it. And if we don't have it, we are depressed and feel powerless. But what is your power? Your power is your gift. And the decisions that you choose to make. As T.D. Jakes pointed out this morning, the power of making the right decision. Don't get upset. Don't blow your top. Oh, I'm working on that. Don't blow your top. Just take your power, assume your power, and make the decision based on your power. As he tells the story of going to London with himself and his wife, and they were not treated kindly by the restaurant waitress or whomever they encountered, he didn't get mad. He just said, he asserted his power, told his wife to let's go, and told the lady to speak to his back. Because obviously she doesn't want his money. And that's the reason when I go to a store, I refuse to spend my money in a store where the cashier or the salesperson is nasty. Because if you don't go in the store and buy something, they don't have a job. So if you choose to do a job in the public where you have to deal with people, leave your troubles at home. Put a smile on your face even though you know you don't want to smile, and I can't smile today because I'm so ticked off. But when you choose to deal with the public, the plastic smile is something you have to practice in the mirror. So when you're looking in the mirror in the morning and you're telling yourself that you love yourself, just practice that plastic smile if you can't give a genuine smile like I do. So instead of being nasty to someone, just smile. And in your heart, you're saying, oh, I'd like to just kick your butt. But they won't know what you're thinking unless they read minds, okay? Because sometimes I can read minds, you see? Like, I go to Walmart and a young man is about to be rude. And I just said, "And oh, you're about to be rude to me now because I'm telling you the right thing?" And he smiles and he says, "No, ma'am, I'm not. I'm just saying." So, you know. So why don't we all do that? And don't think I've forgotten the diabetics that I gave the challenge to last week to give up the carbs and the sugar and see where you go, how much weight you lose, and how better you will become as a diabetic patient. Yes, I have not forgotten the challenge. It's 21 days. It started last week. So, and I would love for you to give me a call and let me know how better you feel, how much better you feel by giving up those carbs and those sugars for 21 days. After the 21 days, you could bring things back into your diet slowly in small portions. Remember that. Small portions is what does it. You don't have to sit at the table and eat your belly full until you can't get up and you want to fall asleep. And then they call it what? Nigritis. That's what they call it. Don't eat and go to sleep. Absolutely not. Eat and move. So what did you find this morning in your boxes of blessings? Remember, I love the gold box, but I love the purple one too. So I open them every single day in my imagination. I don't have physical boxes. I have gold boxes in my house. Yes, I do. But those are not the boxes I'm talking about. I'm talking about the boxes that you can create in your imagination if you don't want to go out to buy them. Make them purple. Make them gold. Switch the strings. So you tie the gold box with the purple string and the purple box with the gold string and open them up every single morning that you wake up. And just know that whatever you're praying and asking God for, because I think most of us do pray. Yeah, I think we do. And we expect answers, but some of us have lots of doubt and thinking, oh, that's not going to happen to me. Oh, yes, it's going to happen to me. If I'm praying for it, I know it's going to happen. And if it's not happening and God doesn't answer it, then the Bible is lying. And I'm hoping that the Bible does not lie. Who wrote the Bible anyway, as my mom likes to ask me? Man, right? Well, keep that in mind as you struggle and as you go about your day today. I'd love for you to keep that in mind. I am going to give a shout out to a brother in Jamaica called Brother Coy Little. How are you today, Brother Coy? I would love to hear from you and speak to you and hear your voice, because you are good at what you do and I definitely need your help in quite a few things, you see. So here we go. It is Tuesday. Time today to have some good thoughts about your career, about your life, your journey to be a success with People 490 with Judith. Yeah. But before we get to that, I have a couple of questions that I'd like to ask. Is it more important for the U.S. to take care of American infrastructure, jobs, and the economy before we go to war in Syria? Is it Senator McCain and Senator Lindsey Graham? Oh my God, have we not learned any lessons from Iraq and Afghanistan? What are we planning to do when we go to Syria? I am so glad to hear that the president announced some more humanitarian aid for the Syrian people. Yes, that's good. But what are we doing for our American people, President Barack Obama, and all the senators and congresspeople up on the hill of Capitol Hill in Washington, D.C.? What are we doing for those people? How are we helping our American brothers and sisters who have no jobs, who are sleeping in their cars, whose homes are underwater, who have to go to the food bank to get their daily bread? What are we doing for Americans in America? Oh my God! Are we all fixing everything around the world and want to fix everything around the world, and we're not fixing our bridges until they fall down in the United States? Are we going to wait until the Brooklyn Bridge or some of those bridges in New York that are so big and always have so much traffic until they crack before we decide to do something? Are we going to push through the president's job bills so that we can get people working? What are we doing for the American people? We always seem to be doing or wanting to do something for the people overseas. And Senator McCain and Senator Graham, they're so passionate about helping Syria. What about helping the American people? Please, somebody, do something. Aren't we supposed to take care of those inside our houses before we go on the street to try to help others? Should we be abusing our children and then go out and be nice to other people's kids? Should we beat our wives and then go out and act as if we are the nice guy? Or should we feed our children, take care of our families, and then go out and help somebody else? Oh my God, I am so sick and tired of hearing about war in Syria and helping the rebels. And who are the rebels? Do we know who the rebels are? How do we know we're not going to give weapons to Al-Qaeda who are in Syria? How do we know? What do we know? And please stop whining about the NSA, because the NSA is a spy agency. I think every government spies on their people. Not think, I know they do. So what are you worried about? Are you worried about giving your information to Google where you search? And giving your information out on Facebook or Twitter? What do you think they do with that information? How do you possibly think that your cell phone knows where you are every step of the way? How do you know? Are you concerned? And all those young people out there whining about they don't trust President Obama anymore, go get a life and go do some research and get yourselves wise and get some wisdom. Because do you really know what you're talking about? You don't trust him because you think? Well, President Obama just whipped everybody today when he said, I am no Dick Cheney, because Dick Cheney is coming out to defend the NSA. And Obama is making it clear, I am not no Dick Cheney. And that's why they have the court, the FISA court. Do you know what that is? That's the court that keeps the NSA and all those people checks and balances. Yes, you go, yeah, okay, you don't trust the court now. Ooh, yeah. But if we're living in oblivion and thinking that we're not being spied on every day since the Patriots Act from 9/11, we are living in Hope Gardens on Denial Street. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you that. And if you're on the phone call talking to your mother or your father or your husband or your wife or your children, and you're saying things that are normal people supposed to be saying, and you're not trying to say you're going to kill somebody or do something to the president or whatever, what are you worried about? Oh, privacy. And do we have any privacy in this world anymore? No, we don't. And that's the reason we give up that, because we can go online and be as smart as anyone else. As my good friend Patrick said to me yesterday, I just love to talk to him. He's so intelligent and so positive. So, what do you know? We whine, and you know, all these research and all these people and these polls and CNN poll and NBC poll and CBS poll. Who the hell are they polling? I've never gotten a call. Is my opinion important, or they're just picking a specific group of people that they know are going to give them the answers that they want to hear? Because a lot of these news organizations, you know, Fox, to name a few, if their goal is to destroy President Obama, because that's what makes them their money from their ads, you have to understand business and how it works. What do you think? Rupert Murdoch? I don't think Rupert Murdoch himself hates Obama. But Rupert Murdoch knows his Fox network makes money if he caters to a segment of the population called the conservatives. And that's why he allowed crazy, stupid people like Palin to raise her head again. Oh, now she's a contributor to the morning show. What the hell does she know? What does she know? How many books has she read? As was being asked by Katie Couric, who has not been able to live that down. Sarah Palin? Oh, she talks about, oh, let Allah save the people in Syria. Hello? She says the craziest things. Oh, and when we elect a president that knows what's going on, you know. Plain and simple, Sarah Palin is either racist, she's either stupid, or she's just in it for the money. Which one you want to choose? Because that's your choice. And I pray and I tell you, she is in it for the money. She does not say these shock things to, you know, make you feel good as a conservative. No. She says it because it gets her on television and people are talking about her again. Don't you see, anytime you don't hear from Sarah Palin for a while, she comes out with a shock jock to get herself in the headlines again. That's all it is. Come on, people, wake up and smell the roses or the coffee or whatever you're smelling in the morning. We need to be sensible and stop acting like we are stupid. And that's the reason the politicians get away with what they get away with. Because we act as if we're stupid and we don't know what's going on. You should make it your business to know what's going on. And now you have it at your fingertips. It's called the internet. You can know what's going on in Britain and Europe and go to the BBC. There are so many news agencies online. Ooh. Online is taking over. I've just started early, like I normally do. Lots of people are getting their television from the internet, from their laptops, their desktop, their iPad, their other tablets, their iPhone, their other smartphones. Yeah, you can pull up the Diana Wright Show right there on your phone if you have a smartphone. No problems. Just put my name in, it comes up. So why are we fooling ourselves, people? Ladies and gentlemen, you need to stop. So should we not take care of here before we try to take care of there, over there? Wow. Okay, my next question is, should the American government pay for crazy people doing crazy things in rescues? Yes, because there are two young people, two teenagers who decided to move away from their parents where they were doing their thing. And oh, they just decided to follow the trail to the top of the mountain. And when they get to the top of the mountain, they say, oh my God, we're in trouble. So they started to scream and holler for people to see them so they could call for rescue. And are we worried about the rescuers? Their life, they have to put their life in jeopardy, in danger, to save some of these crazy people who are doing crazy things. So should we be picking up the tab all the time for that? I don't think so. I think people should think before they do crazy things. Don't go bungee jumping if you are scared and afraid. Don't go on the top of the mountain in California by going on the trail that you don't know where the trail leads to. And then you try to get those guys in the helicopters to come and rescue you, putting their life at risk for you. People, start thinking before you do stupid things. So, here we go. I see that Senator Claire McCaskill from Missouri is saying yes to Ready for Hillary. Hillary Clinton is getting endorsements. She hasn't even announced yet. Are we ready for Madam President or are we not in 2016? The Republicans are doing their darndest best to tie her to Benghazi, to destroy her reputation, to throw the box and the bucket and everything in the sea at her. But people are loving her anyway. Now, are we willing to go out and vote for more politicians who can do nothing when they go to Washington? Or are we thinking that women are more resourceful and women are more thoughtful? But are we also remembering that women can be bees? You know what that means? And they can hack an envious trail and a jealousy trail that you cannot deal with. So keep that in mind as we go about the Hillary business. Okay, I am sure that this is Judith. Hello, Judith. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I love you so much today.
Ah, and how are you doing?
I am doing just fine.
All right. Fantastic. And how is People 490 on this Tuesday morning?
People 490 is doing wonderful. I thank God for Jesus. I thank Him for me. I thank Him for people like you. I thank Him for family and friends. And I thank Him for this beautiful day.
Hallelujah. Okay, so tell us about Saturday. How did it go, your recruiting drive on Saturday?
It went as I expected.
Wow.
I am having fun.
Expectation is a great thing, right?
I am having fun and I agree with you.
Okay.
So, oh, it's so wonderful. It's just a wonderful day. I just feel so good today.
And I am so happy to hear the joy in your voice. So I am now assuming that you opened your gold and your purple boxes and you found blessings in it today.
Oh, what did I find? Blessing or what?
Yes.
I'm blessing the Lord. You know, thinking back to so many things, so many good things that happened to me.
Mm-hmm.
I have no recourse but to say thank you. And even the bad ones, mm-hmm, I have made such good cherry pie out of the bad ones.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. You know, you and I are Taurians, you know, and we seem to go through some way highs And then because everybody think we shouldn't be at that high, they try to cut our feet off, but we always seem to rise. You know, Maya Angelou always says, I'll rise.
Yes, rise. And you know what I think is that a lot of human beings not understand the importance of a gift.
Ah, there you go.
A gift is a gift. What is given to you is yours.
Yes.
And it is yours to use to your advantage.
Absolutely.
And that is what the Lord has given to every single one of us on the face of this earth. And we need to seize the moment and use the gift or gifts that we were given to our advantage and use that to be successful and to help as many persons there are out there as we go along. And I would say this to every single person. When you are given a gift from God, use it.
Yep.
To your benefit.
Absolutely. Okay, so the recruiting drive went well. I'm assuming that from the tone of your voice. And we are looking forward to something else that you're doing in August.
That is what I want to talk about today too. So thank you for getting that.
Yes, your customer service seminar. That's August 3rd. And it's going to be not at 9 this time, but at 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Am I correct?
Yeah, you are correct, but we actually changed the time.
Okay.
It's going to be 9, so you can scratch the 10 and make it 9.
Okay, so we're going to keep 9 as our lucky number.
Yes. We're going to do 9, and then we're going to end at 12, but we're going to have the social etiquette starting at 1 to 2.
Oh, okay, so you're going to do a whole hour on business etiquette then?
Yes, and that's separate and apart from the customer service. And both of them are there's a cost involved.
Okay, well, we understand that, you know, because I keep telling people, ain't nothing free in this life, okay? you got to pay.
Yes, so for the customer service, it's $69. And for the business and social etiquette is $49.
Okay. And who are you catering to for this process?
Primarily for the customer service are small and medium businesses. Or if they're big businesses and they want to join us, you know, that's fine too, because they might have a need for customer service excellence.
Okay.
Training. So I'm really catering. And if there's someone out there who just want to educate themselves on what customer service excellence is, feel free to come and join us.
Okay, let me ask you this though, Judith. If a business, small business, if the owner cannot make it and they send their employees, is that good enough for them to take the message back, or it has to be the owner that comes?
No, actually the owner is important too. But what I want to stress is if you have employees, I think it is best for you to invest in these employees because they can make or break your company. And if they are educated, they, I'm sure, will do a better job than if they are not educated.
Okay.
So I would encourage business owners to invest in your employees,
right?
Because once you invest in them, your company will grow.
All right. Very good, because customer service is the key to every business. I tell you what, even when I go to a store and someone is nice to me when they're behind that register or they're a walking around salesperson, you know I am coming back to that store. And I'm telling everybody I know about that store. Seriously.
Yes, it's true. A word of mouth, you can't beat that advertising.
It is the best advertising on the planet, and it's free.
It is the freebies. And the only thing I think you get for free, as in free.
Yes.
So you probably spent before you got that freebie.
Exactly.
It is free.
Exactly. All right.
It is free.
So what are we going to focus on this morning? We know we have the customer service seminar coming up August 3rd.
Yes.
And it's going to be 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., but from 12 noon to 1.
From 12, 9 to 12.
Yeah, but from 12 to 1 is the business.
From
1 to 2. Okay, is business etiquette. All right. You know that
I'm having some noise around here.
Okay, my pen just died, so I have to depend on my memory.
Never mind.
Yeah, my pen just died. You know, my teeny bang pen just died.
Get a pencil.
Okay, yeah, so I have to go by memory. So let me go by memory here. Customer service seminar. It's going to be August 3rd, and I'm going to show you how good I am now. August 3rd from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., and then the business etiquette will be from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Okay, I got it.
Okay, one little thing in there.
Okay.
It's from 9 to 12.
Okay, from 9 to 12, and then from 1 to 2?
1 to 2.
Okay, yes. All right.
Between 12 and 1, we're going to be breaking up.
Okay, so you're taking a lunch break from 12 to 1. Okay, all right. Perfect. Well, you're allowed to go eat.
Yes.
All right.
So the customer service is $69, mm-hmm. and the business and social etiquette is $49.
Okay.
But I want to emphasize just 2 points here
mm-hmm.
in customer service. What I realize, what some of us need to remember, that some of our customers are new to our business.
Okay.
Therefore, they will have new issues.
Hmm.
Right?
Okay.
So when a customer calls into your company,
mm-hmm.
you should always, always listen to what the customer has to say. Because you might be educated. It might be beneficial to your company. For example, the customer calls in and says, you know, I had to wait so long
mm-hmm.
before someone picks up the phone. Guess what? That could be a little tip for you to tell you that you need to start getting more people on your telephone
mm-hmm.
so you don't lose customers.
Right.
Now, they didn't tell you you need to go get more people, but it's a tip. It says, I had to wait so long. Now, if you have more persons answering the phone,
mm-hmm.
then that customer would not have to wait that long to get service.
Right.
So it could be beneficial to you and also to your customers. And it is important that you be skilled enough, customer-oriented, skilled enough to have the ability to treat the customers, each customer, separately. Separately, by that I mean, you could just hang up from a customer that was just yelling and screaming in your ears. Right? And, you know, it's human, you know, we sometimes
think, oh, yes, we all get mad. I do. I confess I do get upset sometimes, and I pray and ask God to just erase it from me. But I do get mad, but I get mad mostly with my family. When they do stupid things, I just get crazy.
Oh, okay, I'm going to help you to tone that down.
Okay, all right. Especially, you know.
Yeah, sometimes you have a customer that yell and scream and carry on.
Yes.
But once you hang up from that customer, your responsibility
mm-hmm.
is to now dismiss all of what you just went through.
Mm-hmm.
All of it.
Yeah.
And be able to take care of the next customer that is on the line.
Don't carry it over.
Because that customer might just be such a peachy key customer,
mm-hmm.
and you just go on and just rant and rave and carry on and change the tone of the whole thing.
Right.
So it's very important that you know that each customer is different.
Mm-hmm.
The one who is ranting and raving, make sure you listen, listen, listen.
Mm.
And you need to be patient. That's the next step. Be patient. Hear them out.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if they are screaming on top of their lungs.
Mm-hmm.
Hear them out. Listen to them.
Okay.
Because they're gonna stop at one point. I promise you they will stop. If you just sit there and listen.
Oh.
And you need to say to that customer, ma'am or sir, or if you get a chance to get his or her name,
mm-hmm.
you could say, Mrs. Wright, I'm so sorry your experience was as bad as that, but I promise you I will take care of it.
Yeah.
And if they don't want to hear that, I don't want to hear that because everybody said the same thing. Shut up and listen to them. Let them get rid of all of that.
Yeah.
And guess what?
Let them rant.
They're not really personally attacking you, you know.
Uh-huh.
It's the situation that they're in. They're now upset because of whatever the problem is. They're probably purchased something and is not satisfied with it.
Mm-hmm.
And they're calling you to get it straightened out.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
Yeah. Listen to them. And when they are through, you say, Mrs. So-and-so, or if you didn't get the name, you say, my name is Mary Jane, and may I have your name, please?
Uh-huh.
Because if you're going to target them and ask them for their name, for no, you first introduce yourself. My name is Mary Jane, and may I have your name, please? Okay, and I promise that they're going to give you their name.
Mm-hmm.
And once you get that name, you're going to use it to your advantage. You're going to say, Mrs. Wright, I am so sorry, but what I promised to do today is to take it from here and address the problem you're having.
Ah, okay.
By the way, let me give you my direct line. Oh my God, you just give them a value-added product right there.
Yes, yeah.
Let me give you my direct number, and you can call me. And even if you, the representative, is not the person responsible for doing whatever is necessary to make that customer happy, but at this point you are. So you are going to now take it from there to your boss and make it work. Then you're going to now call the customer back, because you're going to assure them that you're going to call them back and say, it has been taken care of, this is what it is, and this is what it is, and this is what it is.
Okay.
That's the value-added product right there. I tell you, they'll go to the ends of the earth to tell everybody, man, I tell you, I was so upset because, but I tell you, Ms. Wright, she just took care of it. She even gave me her direct line. She even called me back, and she took it. Oh, my God. I will not leave that company. That's the best customer service I've ever had.
Yeah.
You got it made.
Success
for your business.
And one of the things I want to remind people about is sometimes the customer that rants and raves becomes your best customer.
Yes, as long as you
sort out the problem.
Excellent customer service.
Yes.
They
truly.
Sometimes they're just mad right there and then, mad because of whatever it is.
Exactly, because sometimes you go to these places, like, you know, I went to Polo Tropical the other day, and they're trying to sell me burnt plantains. And put the burnt ones on the bottom, and then two properly cooked ones on top. And I thought to myself,
they're covering up.
Yes, and I, you know, because I said to the young lady, take it out the bag and let me see it. Because she, you know, they try to bag it up fast enough and hope that you're not going to open up the bag.
Correct.
I'm one of those customers, if you go to buy something that is takeout in a restaurant, always look at what you have just been given before you leave. You leave the restaurant. But a lot of people just don't. They just take up the bag and go. And when she took out the thing, I said to her, "Would you eat those plantains?" She's looking at me like, you know, I don't
speak. And I know you, you know that. Right?
Yes. So I said, seriously.
The expression on your face. Yeah. That question.
Right. So I go, would you eat those plantains? So she said, no. I said, okay. Well, why would you like me to eat them? Okay, so she goes and she throws away those plantains or whatever she did with them, and she said, could you wait? I said, no problem, I'll wait as long as you're giving me proper plantains. Okay, so they come back and they're selling you something that you're supposed to get a whole amount of chicken in it. And okay, every time you go and you buy that product, I only buy it because my daughter likes it, because I don't. Okay, so I asked her, could you tell me how much I'm supposed to be getting in this? She says, I don't know. I said, okay, could you get me a manager? So she gets the manager, and one of the managers who came, I don't know if she is the manager or she's the assistant manager, but she looks important, yeah? So she says to me, yes, you're correct. You're supposed to get XYZ. So I said, this doesn't look like XYZ to me. Then the other manager comes over, who seems to be the manager now, and she says, oh, that's not supposed to be so. So I'm like, okay, which one of you are correct? Am I supposed to get a whole chicken breast, or am I not supposed to get a whole chicken breast? I don't know who to believe right now. I'm confused. So anyway, they decided that what I got was what I was supposed to get. So, and I'm teaching my daughter a lesson in all of this, you know, because she's there and she's watching. And I said to her, when you go to a place, you should not just walk out with a package closed. You should look in it to see what you're getting. So I got home, because this had happened like a couple of times, you know, and you just kind of let it slide. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I got home.
No, you don't let it slide the first time.
Yeah, you know. Okay. Yeah, so I go and I came and I got on my phone. I looked on the receipt, because, you know, on the receipt, they'll trick you. Sometime you call back and you're calling back the same place you just left.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but I called the right number, which was the HQ. And mm-hmm. I got someone, and just like you said, I spoke to her. I said, you know, I've had this experience several times, but today it was just enough, seriously. And this is what I'm saying. So do you know that they talked to me, and they actually called me back. Just what you're saying. Because because a lot of us, we figure that we can only take this out on the little business guy, but the big corporations, I trust. And another lady called me back again and said, would you like us to send you some coupons and, you know, for X amount of dollars? I said, lady, yes, you can send me the coupons, but it's not about the coupons. I'm not looking for anything for free. I'm just looking that when I'm spending my money, I am getting what I'm paying for. That's it.
Exactly.
I'm not looking for anything free, because I am not a free kind of person. You will not find me trying to get free things, okay?
Right.
But what I'm paying for, I'd like to get.
Yes.
And she was so nice and so sweet. And don't worry, Mrs. McLaughlin, we're going to take care of this.
All right.
You know, so you are so correct, Judith. Because, my God, people are so scared. The average person doesn't bother to call. If you don't call, how do you think the company is going to know how to correct the problem?
That's right.
All right. So thank you for bringing that up. So I get to clear my conscience. You know, so.
Yes, but, you know, it's so important. And I have been trying to get this through to a lot of businesses in our community.
But they want it for free, I bet.
Yeah, I find that they are more interested in making the money for the business, and I must admit, that is of paramount importance.
Yes, it is. You have to make a profit.
But I think if you're going to give excellent service, you're going to make more money.
Amen. Amen, people. Are you listening?
So, I am encouraging everyone who especially the ones who are small and medium businesses to either come out and get the training or send your representative to get the training. And you know what? I must emphasize this.
Mm-hmm.
And let me pause. I must emphasize this. Customer service, business and social etiquette is big business, and the cost is high.
Yep. Just try to get TD Jakes to come and talk to your employees and see how much he charges.
Oh, exactly. And if you doubt me, do your own research. Mm-hmm. Not cheap. I am doing this to help my fellow business owners. Mm-hmm. I seriously am doing this because I have experienced some bad customer service.
Yeah.
I have experienced some bad business and social etiquette protocol settings and the whole nine yards.
Mm-hmm.
And I just decided, you know what, let me give them something. So what they're paying for is not really what I'm going to give them.
Mm-hmm.
They're just paying for the handouts that they're going to be getting
right
in there. But the knowledge I'm sharing, going to be sharing with them is worth much more.
Much more.
Hundreds and thousands.
Yes.
I did some research, and some of the persons, and they're just coming to speak for, say, 3 or 4 hours, mm-hmm. okay? And, of course, within that 3 or 4 hours, there might be question and answers or so.
Right.
But, Diana, we're talking some $6,000 to $10,000.
Yes.
Just for that. And they, you will have to pay for every expense.
Their accommodation, their airfare, their entourage, their everything.
That money that you're paying, that $6,000 or $10,000, is their money in their pocket.
Amen.
So I am saying, people, listen and listen up well. Mm-hmm. You're getting a $6,000 to $10,000 package in your lap for $69.49. You can't beat that.
Mm-hmm. So it's $60 and $49. And the $49 is for the etiquette, business etiquette training?
And $69 for the customer service.
Okay, so it's $69 and $49. Judith likes nines, so to see.
Yes, I like the nines.
You're a nine kind of girl. Okay.
Yes, I like the nines.
$69 and $49. The seminar is going to take place on August 3rd. And let me give you the correct times, because I've been kind of giving you the other times before. So it's 9 a.m. to 12 noon, and that's for the customer service seminar. And then they take a break. And then from 1 to 2 is the, what you call?
Business
etiquette. And business etiquette is different from regular etiquette. Trust me, it is. Okay? Lots more intricacies to think about. Like if you go to Japan, there are certain things you must not do. As a business person.
Okay. I could just dissect all of that and do so much with it. Because it's amazing how all of this
mm-hmm.
will work for different countries.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give you a little pointer. If you should be talking to someone from Haiti,
mm-hmm.
for example, an older, respectful person mm-hmm. from Haiti, and you're looking in their eyes,
mm-hmm.
they would take that as something that is so wrong.
Wow.
In America, you look in somebody's eyes, and that's the way to go.
Yes, because that's a seat to your soul in America.
Yes. In Haiti, it tells them, when you do that, that you're being disrespectful. You're tearing them down.
Yeah.
You're being rude.
Especially if you're younger than the person that you're talking
exactly.
to.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If you're in America and you're doing it, then, oh, yes, she looked me right in the eyes and she told me and she told me and she told me.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be careful. There's a lot of things that we need to know. The culture, we need to, you know, there's so much to know. I'm so happy that I know these things.
Yes, because isn't it Japan that you go to and you can't clean your plate or something like that, or you have to clean your plate? One of those, I mean, there's so many little things, And you, it's amazing to me that a lot of business people just don't take the time to research these things. Or they just don't take the time to come and pay $69 to learn it, you know, because it's important. It really is important. Yes. Yeah. Some places
you
need a tie.
They feed you.
Yeah.
If you keep eating the food off the plate, they're going to put more food on the plate. Mm-hmm. And you eat it off, and you put more, they put money, go like, Derek, that's why are you eating the food off the plate? So you don't know better.
Yeah.
And there's so much that I could share.
Yeah.
You know, and the thing is, I don't want to give away too much either. They need to come.
Yeah, they need to come.
And learn these things, because these are things that I pay to learn.
Absolutely. You're giving them the teasers to encourage them to come to the seminar on August. And you know, I'm saying August 3rd, and it seems so far away right now, but it really isn't. Because, we're almost at the end of June already, if you can believe it. And July 4th, the big holiday that we all love to celebrate, is almost on top of us already. So, yeah. So August 3rd is just around the corner. So it's $69 and $49 for business etiquette. Oh my goodness. Wow. I don't think anyone charges that small amount. Seriously.
No, I think that you're just paying for the document.
The handouts,
that's always going to give you some form of handouts. And you remember, someone has to type them.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be printed.
Right.
As I get more detailed, we have to use ink.
Mm-hmm.
Cartridges and all of that.
Right.
So I have to duplicate the copies for everybody. So I'm not trying to be nitpicking, but I'm just explaining to the listeners that it's nothing to write home about. To pay that kind of money. So come on out and join us and get some knowledge.
Yes, knowledge is power.
Yes,
and oneness is greatness, and knowledge is power. So let's use that. All right, Judith, final thoughts before you go. Judith from People 490, and it's people490.com. It's so easy to remember for all this juicy, good information that you need for your business. Please, ladies and gentlemen, if you have a business and you sell chicken, when I come for chicken, don't tell me you ain't got no chicken. Okay, because you are a chicken place, and if you're open, you're supposed to have chicken.
Yes, ma'am. I hear you, and I think that's the final thought right there.
Okay, all right.
Thank you so much, Diana,
and thank you so much for joining us this morning, Judith. Have a great day and a blessed one too.
You too.
All right. Take care. All right. That was People 490, and that was Judith, the director of People 490. Their website, easy to remember, it's people490.com, and great information. Whether you're seeking a job, she will find you one. You're seeking training to get that job, you will find the training at People 490. And of course, business etiquette, it's so important. If you go to Japan, you must know what to do. If you go to some places, you got to take your shoes off and all that kind of stuff. So you want to make sure you get that information before you venture out into your business venture and know what you're doing. We know that you must make a profit, but customer service is key to any business being successful. Seriously, it is. And if you want your customers to come back, be nice to them, because they have the power of the pocket. And the greenbacks in the pocket, or the big old bag that some women carry. I wonder sometimes, what are these women having in their bags? Just like I wonder about cell phones. What are you guys talking about so much? Please let me know. I am serious. I cannot understand what people did before there were cell phones. You pass and you see elderly people talking on the phone, and they're not using the Bluetooth now. They're using the phone up to their ear, which, should we not be using the speaker on the phone at least, so we don't have it in our ears like they advise us to do? Please listen, take advice, and then when you take that advice, use it. So we thank Judith from People 490 for joining us. It's Tuesday, and of course, she joins us then. We're hoping that Dax is back for tomorrow for Wellness Wednesday, but you never know. Iceland may have him hooked, and he decides to stay. No. I don't think Dax is going to stay. I'm not quite sure when he's coming back. I hope he'll be here tomorrow with us. And we just thank you so much for joining us today. Welcome you again from around the world and in the United States. And also, did you know that 7-Eleven is now in the slavery business and the identity theft business? Oh my God! They were bringing in people illegally from different countries to work in their stores. And then they will be stealing identities from the dead and the living to give to these people. And then when they do the paychecks for these people, they would cash the paychecks themselves and take some of the paycheck to give to the people after they're already paying them less than they would pay another worker. 7-Eleven, shame on you. You get my shame list today. My God, are we so hungry and so greedy for money that we will stop at nothing? Even abusing other people, having all these people live in one little quarters. Oh my God. Shameful, 7-Eleven. How many customers do you think you're going to lose now, 7-Eleven? For all of those who you think you might have gained by robbing these workers of their true wages and the profit that you made from that, how much do you think you're going to lose now? So now all 7-Elevens, you know, the ones that were caught were in New York and in Virginia. What do you think is going to happen? The authorities now is going to be suspicious of every 7-Eleven. So all 7-Eleven stores are now going to be under the microscope. Do we actually think about the things we do and the consequences when we get caught? Because I don't care what you think and how good you are, eventually you do get caught. My. Shame. What a shameful thing for 7-Eleven owners to do. Remember, it's a franchise business. Be careful who you franchise to when you start your own little company, because one bad apple could ruin your brand. What is your brand? And if you're selling that brand, my brand is my name, Diana Wright. I had the McLaughlin and people get a little confused because they say it's too long to write. And McLaughlin is too difficult to spell and too hard to pronounce. But it's not really. So what is your brand? Are you willing to protect your brand and not allow other people to ruin it? Because those stores in New York and Virginia, they have ruined the 7-Eleven brand, in my opinion. So be careful who you're selling your brands to. They could be wolves in sheep's clothing. And did you know that sibling rivalry? You know, I don't have any brothers and sisters. I'm an only child. Even though I got a whole lot when I was in Jamaica and my show was a massive hit. Doing so well, everybody wanted to be my brother and my sister. But to my knowledge, I'm the only one that came out of my mother's vajayjay. So, I know that I'm an only child. Yes. And even though I don't know my dad, whomever he cares to happen and have out there, I don't know them and I really don't, you know, want to know. Okay? So, sibling rivalry. If you were mean to your brother or your sister, please know that that form of bullying is just as dangerous, as hurtful, and as affecting to that other person as bullying on the bus or at school or even at work. Because do you know that there are bullies on the job? Yeah, there are some people on the job who want to bully you and you have to stand up. And you have bullies even when you go to a new school and they try to do ragging or whatever they call it. Initiation. I don't want nobody initiating my child when she goes to any new school. No, thank you. She gets initiation at her house, which she doesn't need. Nobody's initiating me at my house, so why would you think you want to initiate me? So, Stop the bullying, even at home with your siblings. It's hurtful, painful, can scar, and do great damage. Okay. Husbands are no longer in high demand. Did you know that? Because women are becoming more self-reliant. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Women are the breadwinners in 40% of American households with children. That's according to the Pew Research Company. And as I asked before, who are these research companies anyway? They call in, who are they calling? Are they calling their favorite people that they know they're going to get their answer for, from, or what? So, it's so good to announce that women are not so desperate to find husbands anymore. And I would just like to add to that, that do you know that when you become a wife, you become the maid too? You have to wash, you have to cook, you have to clean, you have to take care of the children, you have to be the chauffeur for the children. Lots of things that you got to do that you probably don't want to do. And after doing all of that, some of us are fortunate enough to have enough money to pay someone to clean the house. And some of us as celebrities have the opportunity to get tutors and, you know, nannies to raise our children. But should you be using nannies to raise your children? But some of us are fortunate enough to be able to afford that. And if you are Sean Diddy Combs, and if you are J-Lo, and if you are Sharon Stone, you might regret having someone in your house raising your children, because they turn around and they sue you. For what? You don't even know sometimes. So we got to be cautious about who we bring in our houses, and we got to be cautious about who we sell our franchises to. Who you join up with can make or break you. So be careful about who you join up with also. Alrighty. Some other great news about the Supreme Court telling Arizona, no IDs necessary here. Republicans are going to be shocked to know that they cannot steal elections by wanting you to fill out some more paperwork and adding to the frustration of elderly people who want to get to the polls. So the Supreme Court is going to be very busy until the end of this month. Affirmative action comes up too. We'll see what they do with that. So, and we see that Bank of America, they have some whistleblowers in their company now that's telling us the lie that they told them to tell all the customers that were trying to get a modification on their loan. Which other bank is going to be ousted? Come on out of the woodwork, all you employees of all these banks that are not working there anymore, and speak and tell the lie that they told you to tell. And as I started the show and I asked a question, are we willing to go and fight wars in Syria and around the world while our American people sleep in their cars, go to the food bank for food, be homeless with their mortgages and their houses underwater, as you say? Our infrastructure crumbles as our bridges fall down. What are we sacrificing to fight wars around the world? Shouldn't you take care of home first, Capitol Hill and President Obama? Shouldn't you take care of your American people first before you lend a hand to those overseas? Yes, I know you have interests overseas. And yes, I know there's oil to protect and your interest. But aren't we part of your interest? Aren't we the ones who elected you? Are any of those Syrians or those people in Afghanistan or Iraq or Egypt coming to vote for you? No. So, Madam President Clinton, if you plan to run for 2016, the message has got to be good, and you have to make good on your promises. because we realize that once you get to Washington, it's no longer about the people. It's about how much fundraising I have to do to get my next victory. It's about the power that I now have that I can wield and deal for my own family. It's a book deal that I can get. It's a power that Ted Cruz thinks he has and Rand Paul thinks they have. And Marco Rubio, I don't know, is he confused or what? I think I heard something about English. Knowing English before you get your citizenship. I thought that was already done because Oops. We'll see. I would have to get my Pastor Seton back here from Kush to let me know what's really going on behind the scenes of this whole immigration bill. They're trying to pass it before July 4th. We'll wait and see because July 4th is just around the corner. Okay. There are lots more things here, like the graduates in going to the prestigious Purdue University who decided to break into their professor's office and get the code and change their grades. My God, what are we doing in this world these days? Is there honesty anywhere? And would you like that engineer who changes grade to be your engineer in your company? No, absolutely not. So those are some of the stories that I have to give you in more detail as we go through the week. And did you know that being single is actually quite expensive? It's more expensive than getting married to be single. I'll give you the details on that too. Just giving you a rundown of all of these things. And okay. Wow. Nigella Lawson. The lady that cooks up her magic in the kitchen. Well, she's married to one of the big wigs in advertising who obviously pushed her to make... You know, we women, sometimes we marry to these powerful men. They help us to get to where we want to go. But if they're going to choke you, now, you ain't having it. And we gather that it's more than one time that he's abused her publicly in a restaurant. Your husband is going like this. And then he's going to tell me it was a playful tiff. Hell no, we don't believe you, Mr. Saatchi. Your advertising agency make millions and billions around the world, but we are not buying that. There is no man on this planet that will have his hand to my throat in a restaurant and then come out and give a quote that you were having a tiff about the children. Hello. Come on, Mr. Old Man Saatchi. Get it together. And I see now, if you're doing that in public, can you imagine what Nigella is suffering at home? And if she's not woman enough to come out and speak the truth, then women will continue to be abused. So again, I say, no envy, no jealousy. My grandmother always told me, don't envy the other person for what they have. You don't know what they're going through to get it. Nigella has risen, written books, and done so well on the Food Network. And now she's on ABC in some program called The Taste, some reality show. But what does she have to do to be famous? I'm not willing to get my throat squeezed to be famous. I will do it, what I'm doing right now, the Diana Wright Show, live online. Until the profit comes, until the sponsors come, the advertisers come, and the partners come. We will do it this way. And again, I thank you so much for joining me today. Hope you have a blessed day and do join me for the 8 o'clock hour with Dr. Melanie Simpson, hoping that all things work well and equal for that to happen. Have a great day. Have a blessed day. Like us on Facebook. Tell a friend. Phone a friend. Tell them about the show. And we hope that you found your blessings like Judith did in your boxes that you opened this morning. And we leave you with the thought. So easy it is, because it is just a simple sandwich to make that we all love in America, except me. I just simply say, I love me every day. But if you need to put it in a sandwich of I, the love in the middle, and the me at the bottom, that's okay too. So sandwich the love with I and me and make it I love me every single day of your life. as you move forward and as you press forward. And know that all things are possible, not some things, not maybe nine things. When you believe, when you have faith, when you trust, when you have hope, and when you pray, without doubt, it will come to pass. So as I say adios, ciao, and au revoir, I remind you, if you love something, set it free. If it comes back, it's yours. If it doesn't, it was never yours. Have a great day, a blessed day, and see you at 8. Remember, three little words. I love me. That's my crusade. What's yours? Doobie doobie doo. Be doobie doobie. Doobie doobie doo.